In this video, we will show you how to configure your Batch Quick Lister settings in WiseLister. Your Batch Quick Lister settings in WiseLister are general settings that will apply to all listings as a default. You will be able to change them individually per item as you list if needed. Once you are logged into WiseLister, click on Batch Quick Lister settings in the left side navigation area. Use Seller Profiles. These are your eBay business policies. You will need to change this option to yes, as eBay will require you to use business policies seller profiles. Click Get Update Profiles. This will fetch in your policies from eBay. Note, if you need to make changes to your policies, you should do that first in eBay Business Policy Management and then come back into your settings and click Get Update Profiles. Select the payment seller profile that you want to use by default. Select the return seller profile that you want to use by default. Select the shipment seller profile that you want to use by default. Next is quantity. Enter the default quantity for your listings. Note, if you are using SKU Grid and are listing with a different default quantity in WiseLister than you have in your SKU Grid setting, then WiseLister will override the SKU Grid setting and your listing will be maintained by SKU Grid at the default quantity that you listed with. Next is listing duration. This is the duration for your listing. We recommend listing with good till cancel listings as they generally perform better with any repricing solution. However, you can make whatever selection you want here. Do not leave this option set to 1 day as eBay will not allow it. Next is location. This is the general item location, not your physical location. You can enter a city name here, or some people prefer to use multiple locations. Country is the country where the item is located. By default, this should be the country you're selling on unless you are using a supplier that ships internationally from another country. In which case, you'll also need to make sure you have selected a shipment profile above that reflects that as well. Next, enter your PayPal email address where you will be accepting payments. Sales tax, flat rate if not using tax table, should be left blank. eBay does not allow you to charge a flat sales tax rate. If you're charging sales tax, you'll have to set up the eBay sales tax table on eBay directly and use the option below. For Use Sales Tax Table, select Yes if you are authorized to collect sales tax and have set up the eBay sales tax table, or select No if you are not using the sales tax table. Click Show More. Next is the Shipping Services section. Note, if you have not selected to use Seller Profiles Business Policies above, then you will see many more options below for setting up a shipping service as well as return options. But as mentioned, seller profiles are required by eBay, so you should have that option selected and will have to configure less settings in this section as a result. Dispatch time is the amount of days you need from the time a buyer makes a purchase to ship the item out to them and upload tracking to eBay. Make a selection here. Restocking fee should be left at none as eBay no longer allows restocking fees. Postal code is the postal code where the item is located. If you're using seller profiles and are using a flat shipping policy instead of calculated, you can leave this field blank. For global shipping, select yes or no here. But note that whatever you have in your shipping policy rules over whatever you select here. Click Save. You've now successfully configured your Batch Quick Lister settings in WiseLister. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.